It's good to have you back. You're still watching You Special. In case you've just joined us on the show today, we're doing design schools in the capital. Before we left you for the commercial, we were talking about footwear design. I've shifted base now to the Apeejay Institute of Design, sitting with a bunch of aspiring interior designers. To my right, we've got second year students. To my left, more senior third year ones. We're going to start off with Shivani. You've done this more recently. How do you get into a design institute? What exam did you guys have to give to get where you are today?
Okay, for this you have to first give an entrance exam. It's the written entrance exam. And after that you have an interview. That's the only thing that you have to do.
How is this exam different? Would it be the same as any engineering entrances? Is interior designing and architecture slightly similar?
Basically, it's a little different from engineering, where in this institute they actually test your more of your creative and your conceptual skills more than anything else. That's an aptitude test. When you come into the institute, they want you to be more specifically, emphasizing on concepts more than anything else. That's what they want.
But does someone have to have a particular bent of mind when they want to do interior designing? How does someone sitting in class 10 or 12 today sitting there know that interior design is something that's meant for them? Like personally for you, why did you choose interior design?
Basically, when I was in 10th, it fascinated me since from my house itself. Then finally I landed up I want to be an interior designer. Mm-hmm. And then I searched in and Apeejay is the best for it, so I just enrolled.
As early as 10th, what about you? How early did you decide?
Add there that it's something that you need to already have in you. You need to have that spirit.
I asked this at the Footwear Institute that we were a few minutes ago, and is it a skill that can be taught? Can you be an absolute?
This is one subject that cannot be tutored or learned. It's something that you already have, and here you just cultivate it with the help of the teachers and the faculty and whatever knowledge you get.
Honestly speaking, was it everyone's first choice over here? Is interior designing what you wanted to do? Coming here, what did you experience in the course? Does it fulfill what you thought would be an interior designer?
Yeah, exactly. It's teaching even more than that, because it's even covering a bit of architectural parts than interior designing.
Right, okay. And how much would a course like this cost you?
Like 80,000 to 85,000 per annum.
Like one thing I noticed over here is there's one guy and so many of you. Is this the general proportion of the class also? As in, is it one guy to five girls?
Not actually, but... Yeah.
You can be honest if you want.
Yeah, probably in my batch I'm the only guy doing it.
You're the only guy. Is that a good thing? I would imagine it's a good thing.
Yeah, probably.
So, but is it a woman-dominated profession? Is that true, or is it just in this
institute? No, it's just like that.
Right. Okay. Can you tell me also how much of it is divided into practicals or theory? Most Delhi University courses, a day in a DU college life would be going to class and mostly lectures. How about over here?
More like practical stuff being done. Theory is less, and there is theory, but there is more of practical, because we have to actually practically do stuff. And
practically
learn.
Do stuff. Can you define stuff for us?
That is designing some product, or designing a room or a bathroom or anything which is practically we have to actually go and see first, and then we have to design it accordingly to the client's profile.
What's in including the market?
Okay, in first semester we had basically hardware, the raw materials that we use. We had wood, we had soft furnishings. But now we have an advanced stage. Now we have materials like glass, stone. We need to study about the material, how it works and how is it separated. It includes architectural aspects in it.
I'm very glad you bring up materials. We're going to give people a closer look at your laboratories and your colleges. But before that, does color play a big role? Like, are you also taught about how a certain color will set a particular mood, how some colors work with certain materials?
Absolutely. You have to, when you're doing interiors, you have to reflect the mood of a person wherever he's going, whether it's an office, whether it's a room, whether it's anything. You have to reflect the mood of that person. What does he exactly want?
And is that the kind of skill that she was talking about when she said that it's not something that can be taught? You have to have a sort of inbuilt ability to figure out what works for whom.
Absolutely. Yeah, exactly. So I would just like to add that color does play a very major role, because if the room is very well balanced design, but ultimately it's the color that's going to reflect the person's as well as the designer's point of view.
Second and third year students of interior design, we're going to be finding out a little more about their course, what's their version of an internship, what's the job market looking like. But before that, here's a closer look at the Apeejay Institute of Design.
The institute boasts of a specialized faculty and infrastructure catering to its students' every need. From computer labs with the latest software to carpentry workshops, the Apeejay Design Institute provides its students with the best possible hands-on experience.
We Apeejay, you've just gotten a closer look at the Apeejay Institute of Design. We're still trying to figure out what goes into becoming an interior designer here with students. You want to start with telling us where we're sitting right now, how much of your time you spend in a place like this?
Well, this is our designing studio. We work here for about 6 hours. And we have a drafting table, drafting board, we have pin up our drafting over here.
Right. Do you come to this place only when you have specific projects in mind, or an everyday classroom at a design school will look like this?
No, generally the design process subjects are done over here. Right. And we do all our drafting and rendering and all that stuff, whereas all the projects like the workshop, it's done in the workshop that is downstairs. And we make our furniture pieces over there.
Tell me, I've always wondered that at a design school, do you progress? Do you go on from designing furniture to a room and then to an entire house and then to an office? How does the process start and
yes,
where
basically
does it take
in the foundation, we start with basic things like the standards and all, and gradually we design a room first, and then we design a whole flat or apartment like that.
Right. When you enter something like interior designing, are you taking a sort of risk, or would you say that today there is a large market for young interior designers? What do internships look like at this college?
Definitely, there's a big market. There's no as such risk, and if you really work hard on your you have to definitely start with the basic. Mm-hmm. You have to be clear with your basics, and then you can actually progress.
And what does an internship look like at a design school? Is working along with studying part of your curriculum?
Well, obviously, while we are here, we are just learning. So when you go out into the industry, that is when you actually learn how things work in the market. Practical aspect of anything is very important. You can't do anything without it.
Do you guys work in groups mostly, or when you're told to design something, say like the sketches that we're seeing to our left and right?
The sketches are mostly always individual. Or obviously, there are projects like tables and whole furniture set, for example, then we do that in groups.
Tell me, is there a rule in this college that for every 8 girls there will only be 1 boy? Like, why is it always like, even the last time we met with students, it was only 1?
Right. It's generally that, it's the ratio, it is more of a girls unity over here, so
There's more girls,
more women-oriented profession. We asked this in the last discussion also.
It's not like that.
Right.
Boys are most opting for this.
Do you feel in any way they overtake you when it comes to creativity, or
yeah,
you're equally at par?
Yeah, equally at par.
You're equally at par.
Yeah.
Okay. Does the college help you out with placements when it comes? Is there like, or do you have to go out there and then look for yourself?
Like in the third year, we have to do internship for 1 month, and in the fourth year, we go for 3 months training. So yeah, it really helps out.
Will a lot of you want to be starting off something on your own, like start off your own venture, or is it really too soon to be thinking about something like that?
Well, I think it's really soon to think about that, because you need an experience under some, known persons.
Right, too soon when it comes to deciding between entrepreneurship or actually working under someone, but we're going to be catching up with Priyanka and Pragya, two ex-students of the Apeejay Institute of Design, just to find out what is it like passing out of here and then fending for yourself in the real world.
Hi, I'm Priyanka Mishra. I am an ex-student of Apeejay Institute of Design. My subject was interior designing in Apeejay, and I'm presently working in Incubus.
I'm Pragya Vidya. I am an ex-student of Apeejay Institute of Design and done interior designing from here. And presently I'm working as an intern in Dimension Designer, that's based in GK2.
Recently when I joined the college, I knew nothing about interior. Like, I just knew that, you have to just design something, it's like some kind of a room or something in terms of interior. I just knew that. But when I came to the college, there were a lot of things which I learned in the college.
As of now, as of an intern, we first go check out the materials that we're supposed to do. We see all the materials which are upcoming materials. We see that for the first half. I mean, for like 2 hours we see that, then we start with our projects. Whatever project is going on, we handle that. We take a break. In the filler time, we go back again to the materials, because materials is something which is very vast and which one needs to know by heart. Like, everything you should be knowing, what is the material that you want to use.
So presently I'm working with this firm, I'm getting exposure, and later if I think that I'm capable enough to start something of my own, and definitely do so.
And that is a wrap on our show. If you're part of a design school or institute that we haven't featured on the show yet, you can write into us, tell us about your college campus. If you like what we see, our next show could be from your college. Our address is metronation@ndtv.com. You've all been on U Special. Until next time, bye-bye.